What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video on the channel. Today we've got our roster update predictions. Silvers going to golds and then golds going to diamonds. We have quite a few to go over in this video today, so buckle up and get your stubs ready for some investments. Some will be better than others, and then as always, they may not be going get upgraded. This is all MLB the Show's choice. These are just my predictions. The way I make my predictions is I go over their last 15 days, and for pitchers, also last 15 days, typically like three games there, and also how they've been doing in the last for the season, basically, and a three-year average. So that's how we make our choices for our list. So let's get started with our first silver to gold. First guy on our list here, 79 overall, Ryan Pressly, in his last 5.2 innings pitched, this is last 15 days, 0 earned runs, 10 strikeouts, and 2 saves with a .40 whip on the year. Even more impressive on the year here too, 1.8 ERA, 30 innings pitched, 35 strikeouts. So you can kind of see there, his strikeouts per 9 in the last 15 days is absolutely up, or at least on the up. And then his whip is .93, so definitely deserving of a gold card. So Ryan Pressly, first guy on the list. Right now he's going for $646 on a sell now. His buy now is at $915, but there's still some stubs to be made there if you get him around $650 stubs still. So we got a couple of days, but he's still just around that $650, so you can still make stubs on this Ryan Pressly. Next, we've got the 79 Adalberto Mondesi, who recently has just come back from an injury. I don't remember what injury it was, but in his last 11 at-bats, last 15 days, 2 home runs, 4 RBIs, a .364 batting average with a slugging percentage of 1.091. He's been at 79 basically all season, and now that he's back, showing some power so far on the year. He does have 4 home runs, but most of those home runs came, if not all, I don't remember if he played earlier in the season, but 4 home runs, .361 batting average, does not need much to get updated to an 80 overall gold, so he is going to be gold for sure sometime this season. I just don't know if it's too early right now. I don't know if they're going to take into account that he just came back, but Adalberto Mondesi definitely having a gold season so far. Next, we have the 78 overall, Trevor Rogers, another pitcher who's having another great season. In his last 13.1 innings pitched, 14 strikeouts, 2.08 ERA with a .69 whip. On the season, he's got a 1.87 ERA, 81.2 innings pitched, 95 strikeouts, and a 1.016 whip. Now, he does need to jump 2 spots here to get to the 80 overall gold, but I think he can do it. At 840 stubs with 710 sell now, there's still some to be made with this Trevor Rogers, but not too much. I would say Ryan Pressly. If Ryan Pressly stays around that 650 range, go for him first. But if you're a Marlins fan, this is good. This is good for you guys. Trevor Rogers, gold. So Pablo Lopez has been on my radar for quite a few, basically almost all season, for a goal. Pablo Lopez, they jumped him up to a 79 overall, but he's continuing to pitch well enough that I think he is going to be getting a gold in his last 15 days, which is 18 innings pitched. He's gotten 17 strikeouts. 3 ERA looks a little bit inflated there with a .78 whip, but on the season, 2.86 ERA, 85 innings pitched, 85 strikeouts with a 1.071 whip. So the hits per 9 can go up. Case per 9 can probably stay where it's at, but just a little bit more for Pablo Lopez. Those that have been holding on to him, I think you're going to see a 1 attribute bump for Pablo Lopez. Again, right now, 905 for the buy now, but if you buy him around 680, you should be able to make some pretty good stubs with Pablo Lopez still. Now, for these guys that are like borderline going to gold, these prices will go down if they do not. So just keep stacking up on them. Like, typically when players play well, the only thing that's going to stop them from playing well in the season is an injury. So it's safe to say that Pablo Lopez will be going gold at some point in this season. Next, we've got 78 overall Brian Reynolds switch hitter. Right now, his price is $695 at a sell now. Buy now at $892, so still stubs to be made in the last 15 days. He is absolutely hot. 46 at-bats, 4 home runs. He's got a 370 batting average. Slugging percentage is a little bit lower at 696. OPS at 1.116. And on the season, Brian Reynolds at a 12 home runs. So 58 and 53 power. You see that? He's got 12 home runs on the season, 302 batting average. So the power numbers definitely have to go up a little bit. This inside edge is bugged out right now, it seems like. They're giving him a +5 to contact versus right and power versus right, but his inside edge does have him playing down, so that's kind of weird. I don't know why it's doing that, but Brian Reynolds can make that 2 jump, and I think he does. He's playing well enough on the season, absolutely deserving of a gold. So kind of like Brian Reynolds, Cedric Mullins showing some good power on the year at only 65 and 52 power. In his last 15 days, 4 total home runs. Average isn't as good as what he's had throughout the year at 260 batting average. But on the year, 13 total home runs, 310 batting average for Cedric Mullins. He had a couple of good games there last week. So power numbers definitely need to go up. His inside edge right now brings him up to an 82. He doesn't even need that +15 to get him up to the 80 overall gold. But with how well he's been playing these last couple of weeks, I think he makes the jump. Absolutely. So now we're going to jump into our gold to diamonds. We have quite a few here. We have 7 gold to diamonds. Could be more, but these 7 are my pick. And it's going to be absolutely a big roster update, because like I said, there could be more gold to diamonds that we've seen ever in any roster update. This could be the biggest one, and I have 7 for you guys. And don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and whatever you do, make sure you have post notifications on as well, so you never miss a video. Our next guy, good to see Craig Kimbrel playing well once again for the Cubbies. Not good for a Brewers fan like myself, but doing well for himself with the Cubs. His last 5.2 innings pitched, 8 strikeouts, 0 earned runs, 0.19 whip, and on the season, 0.61 ERA, 29.1 innings pitched, 49 strikeouts, 0.64 whip. He's basically untouchable right now. One of the top closers in the game right now. Craig Kimbrel absolutely deserves a diamond here. And he might have the biggest jump from gold to diamond. Maybe an 87 overall Craig Kimbrel we're going to be able to see here. Right now, he's still, you can still make some stubs off of him here at 4,100. If you do buy him at 4,100, do not sell him for 5,000 in the market. Make sure you do a quick sell. But I think if he's up to like an 87 overall, he could sit around like 6,000 stubs for a little bit. But don't ever sell a diamond at 5,000 when you can quick sell them at 5,000 without being taxed. Because if you sell them at 5,000 in the market, you're gonna get that 10% tax, and technically you're only gonna be getting 4,500 back. But if you quick sell them at 5K in the inventory, you don't get taxed on that. So you see the difference there. But yeah, Craig Kimbrel, our first gold to diamond on this list today. Let's move on to our next guy. We've got the 84 overall Zach Wheeler. I know Shelfie's been asking for this for a while now, but Zach Wheeler in his last 17.2 innings pitched, 22 strikeouts, 1.59 ERA, 1.18 whip. And on the year, 2.36 ERA, 99.1 innings pitch with 122 strikeouts, 0.97 whip. Absolutely a diamond. We mentioned in our last update that Zach Wheeler was not going to be going diamond in that update, and that we thought Tyler Glasnow would get it before him, and we were right about it. But this time, it's Zach Wheeler's turn. There's no more putting it off. Zach Wheeler is a diamond. He's currently at 4,300, so still a few hundred stubs to be made there. But not a lot. A lot of people are jumping on these investments. They know that they can make stubs, so there's not a lot of stubs to be made on investments anymore. But if you're there early, guys, like the silver to golds, I feel like those are the most important ones to keep track of, are silver to golds. Because if you buy them early, And then even if they get up to this 4,000 range, you can still make stubs that way, right? Because you're buying those silvers before they hit 1,000 stubs. So like I said, the only thing that bars players from continuing to play well is an injury. So silver to golds, go watch it again. I think everyone's pick in every video I've seen and everyone that I've talked to, Shohei Ohtani is at least on 99% of those lists, and for a good reason. We haven't had Shohei Ohtani on any of our lists this year only because his pitching is, I think, what's weighted massively on his card since he is a starting pitching card. But I think it's finally time for Shohei Ohtani to go diamond. We can't let SDS not give him a diamond live series card because Shohei Ohtani, maybe they switch him to, I don't know, an outfielder or a DH card. But I think the only thing holding this back is that it's a starting pitching card. But Shohei Ohtani, this is going to be a diamond this time around because you cannot ignore his last 42 at-bats, 7 home runs, 333 batting average, a slugging percentage of .905, OPS of 1.333, and on the year, he's got 23 home runs, 269 batting average, okay, but we've seen diamonds at around that average anyways. We're not even going to worry about his pitching stats, guys. We're not going to worry about his pitching stats because his hitting stats need a massive boost. He needs a massive upgrade. He's Shohei Ohtani, and people think so as well. So look at his price. His price has been hovering around that for a while now. People want him to be diamond, and he absolutely needs to be diamond this time around. So you cannot ignore those stats anymore, ladies and gentlemen. So 85, 86, I would say. 86 overall for Shohei Ohtani is what they're probably going to give him, but I just don't know what they're going to do because I think the only thing that's going to make his card move is his starting pitching attributes, basically. Next guy on the list is 84 overall, Marcus Semien, who got a diamond monthly card, but I think his card will definitely, his live series will definitely get a diamond this time around. His power numbers are good in his last 15 days. Average is kind of so and so, but 5 home runs in the last 15 days, a .220 batting average, but on the year, 18 total home runs, .279 batting average, and continuously swinging the bat well. So 80-70 power with 18 home runs can get a slight boost there. Contact definitely needs a slight boost, and he does not need much. He only gets a +1 on contact versus left and power versus left there, but look where it brings him up to. It brings him up to an 85 overall gold. So even if he just gets that +1, Marcus Semien is definitely going diamond. You can make more stubs on this Marcus Semien still, because I feel like people seeing that .220 batting average in the last 15 days, their confidence in Marcus Semien is kind of low, but I think he definitely does go diamond in this roster update. So pick him up, make like 1,000 stubs each on Marcus Semien right now. Next, we've got 84 overall, Carlos Correa, who is absolutely hot in his last 15 days. 4 home runs, .364 batting average, and on the year, 14 home runs, .295 batting average. This one's an easy one. This one's an easy pick. 84, Carlos Correa, who was a diamond before, so you know his averages for the last few years are still pretty good. Right now, currently, you can probably only make about 600 stubs each on this Carlos Correa, so there's a lot of confidence that he will be going diamond. I'm not sure how many people have him on their list, but there you go, another diamond. And then we're actually gonna move on to his teammate, Jose Altuve, who's also doing very, very well. Jose Altuve at 83 overall, putting up some big home run numbers in the last 15 days. 7 total home runs in the last 15 days. .263 batting average. On the year, Jose Altuve's got 16 home runs, .293 batting average. So he's actually playing better than his counterpart, Carlos Correa. And his overall is actually lower at 83 overall. So he's playing better. We think Carlos Correa is going to be going diamond, so why not Jose Altuve as well? So if they're seeing what I'm seeing here, Altuve is having a better season than Correa, and Correa is having a diamond season. So Jose Altuve, another former diamond, should get a diamond this time around. If not, he is a little bit cheaper. Price might go down. Pick up more Jose Altuves if he does not go diamond this time around, because you'll be making some good stubs with this card. So we're gonna go ahead and close it out here with our final gold to diamond, guys. Another hot hitter right now. We've got 84 overall Starlin Marte at, in his last 15 days, only one home run, but a 318 batting average, and on the season, five home runs, 321 batting average. So power numbers not gonna move much. He's got a slugging percentage of 0.504 and an OPS of 0.931, but I mean, that contact is gonna get a boost. He continues to hit the ball well. So that is your final gold to diamond for today. If I missed anyone that you think is gonna be going diamond, let me know in the comments down below. But Starlin Marte here, 3672, can make some good stubs with this card. So go out there, invest, guys. Investing is probably one of the best ways to make stubs in MLB The Show 21. So make sure you go ahead and do that. At least pick up some of these cards so you can make your progress towards a God Squad, towards Chipper Jones, whatever you want to do with those stubs, whether it's packs or, you know, whatever you want. Make sure you guys do some investments. This video is here to help you guys out and make sure you get pointed to the right place. But I hope this helps. Make sure you leave a like on the video with a subscription if you are new. And don't forget to turn on post notifications so you never miss a video. Don't forget to check out my socials, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter. I'll see you guys there. I post a lot. So thank you all so much for watching. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one.